is Michael from Red Chair Diaries in Nova Scotia. This is a, what did I used to call them? Rambling man from the Malibu, but this is the Red Chair Scion IQ. And I'm due at work in about half an hour, but I ended up here early. It's 25 degrees Celsius today, which is about almost 80 degrees Fahrenheit, I think. 25 by 2 is 50, and at 30, yeah, so close to it anyway. And so I'll take this opportunity to talk about the movie I watched last night that we recorded from our premium movie channel. So this is The Debt, based on the an Israeli movie. And it starred Helen MIRREN, the ubiquitous Tom Wilkinson, the ubiquitous Ciarán Hinds, and the not quite ubiquitous, but seemingly so, coming along, Sam Worthington. So this was the clash of the titans all around, I suppose. And Jessica Chastain, I believe, was the one playing Helen MIRREN as a 20-ish or 30-ish Mossad agent. So the story had two timelines. So it's taking place around 1965, 1966, and there's an, a mission to, I think, kidnap I don't have any notes with me, so it's not the Butcher of Lyon, that was a real person, the doctor of something or other. Anyway, he was a bad guy. And he had done experiments and so on in World War II. So remember, World War II was only two decades before that this was taking place. And then the alternate timeline was in 1997, I believe. So in 1997, Helen MIRREN's, I think her name was Rachel, and her daughter wrote a book about this mission. So you had... if I got the names right, you had Rachel is the Helen MIRREN character, David is the Sam Worthington and Ciarán Hinds character, and I think Stephan is the Tom Wilkinson, and I don't remember the other actor's name, sorry about that. So they have the mission, and it's taking place in East Berlin, and something goes wrong, as happens. And I don't have to give you the whole story because basically these stories write themselves, I suppose. And so they basically, and this is the gist of the story, so it's safe to tell it to you. They basically enter a pact that weaves the story that they agree to, which is that she killed this fellow, but he had actually made an escape. And then you've got complications, of course, 30 plus years later. I've got to say, I guess I like this sort of story. It's kind of like Spielberg's Munich Light. It's not as dense because it doesn't have as many characters, many players. It doesn't have the 72 Olympics as a background and that sort of thing. But it's a story about Israel, getting revenge or whatever. And I support them in this. I think that they should be doing this, or that they did it for a long time, and more power to them. And I'm not Jewish born and bred, but I do accept all the stories about the Holocaust and all of the troubles over the millennia. And Israel's hands are not completely clean by any means, but I think that they have a right to go after people. But not everybody will agree with me. Anyway, I'm getting off topic as usual. I want to talk about the acting. I thought the acting was wonderful, and unlike in an upcoming review that you may watch of mine about The Prestige, where I mentioned that I think I could see Christian Bale acting, when you see Helen MIRREN and then Jessica Chastain as the young Helen MIRREN, They were fantastic. There wasn't an acting sort of patina over it. You know, they just seemed to be inhabiting those characters. Sam Worthington, I thought, acquitted himself quite well because, aside from Avatar, I think his roles have been pretty cartoonish, and I thought he did a very good job. He's not present in the movie in some ways to a great degree. He doesn't have as much screen time as Jessica Chastain, but I thought he did very, very well, and I think that he really needs to do a movie with Pierce Brosnan. They don't look the same, but they look like they could be related. I just think it would be an interesting thing to be the son of Brosnan in a movie. What else? I am getting tired of Tom Wilkinson, seeing him in so many movies, and I'm not so sure that he changes all that much in his movies, but, you know, I mean, he is a good actor, and good actors get work quite often. I thought the action was good. It wasn't overdone. It had action, but it didn't have pyrotechnics, and it didn't have nonsense. It just had suspense, and I like that sort of thing. You know, where they're trying to pull off a caper. I like that. I think it had a really good sense of place. It was photographed in Israel. A lot of the interiors are done in the Ealing Studios in England, in London, I guess. And I think it might have been in some other places that were pretending to be East Berlin. But I'm not so sure it was actually filmed anywhere near Germany. But I really recommend this as another cerebral movie. It is not a difficult movie to follow, but it's not a childish movie. It's not just, a shoot 'em up. It's got those big themes about man's inhumanity to man, the concept of whether one should seek revenge when one is in the position to actually have somebody's life in their hands. Do you become that villain if you choose to kill them? You know, these are eternal themes that I think are very, very interesting. So I highly recommend this version. I will probably never see the Israeli version. I've seen this, and this is accessible to me. And I really, really liked it as a good narrative. And it was wasn't hard to follow with the flashbacks, because, of course, you know, as soon as you saw the actors, you knew what time period you were in. Anyway. This is it for now, and when I go home tonight, I'll have a chance to convert this over and upload it. So, anyway, this is using my BlackBerry Playbook on a very hot Sunday, and it's Michael from Red Share Diaries from the IQ. See you around the tube.